like David danced. When the Spirit of the Lord comes upon my heart, I will dance like David danced. When the Spirit of the Lord comes upon my heart, I will dance like David danced. Oh, I will dance, I will dance, I will dance like David danced. When the Spirit of the Lord comes upon my heart, I will dance like David dance. When the Spirit of the Lord comes upon my heart, I will dance like David dance. Spirit of the Lord comes upon my heart, I will sing like David sang. When the Spirit of the Lord comes upon my heart, I will sing like David sang. Oh, I will sing, I will sing. When the Spirit of the Lord comes upon my heart, I will pray like David prayed. When the Spirit of the Lord comes upon my heart, I will pray like David prayed. I will pray, I will, I will pray.
Of the Lord, we le damos la bienvenida a cada uno, ¿verdad? A la casa del Señor, amen. A todos los amigos, ¿verdad? A la comunidad, to the community and the friends, amen. And to all the churches, a todas las iglesias, amen. So we are to read the word of the Lord, amen. And I don't know if somebody has an English Bible. Is that? I'm gonna read in both. Praise God. Praise God. Amen. We're going to be reading on Psalms 111, chapter 111, Salmo 111. Praise God. Lo que lo tengan pueden decir un amén. Praise God. And the word of the Lord, se lee en el nombre del Padre, del Hijo, del Espíritu Santo. Amen. Alabaré a Jehová con todo el corazón. en la compañía y congregación de los rectos. Grandes son las obras de Jehová, buscadas de todos los que le quieren. Gloria y hermosura es su obra, y su justicia permanecen para siempre. Praise God. Ha hecho memorable sus maravillas, clemente y misericordioso es Jehová. Ha dado alimento a los que le temen, para siempre se acordará de su pacto. El poder de sus obras manifestó a su pueblo, amén, dándole la heredad de las naciones. Las obras de sus manos son verdad y juicio, fieles son todos sus mandamientos. Afirmado eternamente y para siempre, hechos en verdad y en rectitud. Rendición ha enviado a su pueblo, para siempre ha ordenado su pacto. Santo y temible es su nombre, el principio, la sabiduría es el temor de Jehová. Buen entendimiento tienen todos los que practican sus mandamientos, su loor permanece para siempre. Praise ye the Lord, I will praise the Lord with my whole heart, in the assembly of the upright and in the congregation. The works of the Lord are great, so out of all them that have pleasure therein. His work is honorable and glorious, and his righteousness endureth forever. He hath made his wonderful works to be remembered. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion. He hath given meat unto them that fear him. He will ever be mindful of his covenant. He has shown his people the power of his works, that he may give them the heritage of the heathen. The works of his hands are virtue and judgment. All his commandments are sure. They stand fast forever and ever, and are done in truth and uprightness. He sent redemption unto his people. He hath commended his covenant forever. Holy and reverent is his name. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding have all they that do his commandments. His praise endureth forever. Amen. Praise God. I'm going to give the opportunity to Ashley, amen, to just give thanks for the word that has been read. Vamos a dar gracias por la palabra. Praise God. Gracias, Señor. Amen. Te damos gracias por esta palabra preciosa, esta palabra que sigue haciendo, oh Dios mío, cambio en muchas vidas, Señor. Alrededor del mundo tú sigues, Señor, Dios mío, salvando vida a través de tu palabra grabada en páginas, Señor, Dios mío, aleluya. Gracias por este instrumento que tú nos has dado. Amén. Praise God. Nuestro hermano Joshua.
God bless you all. God bless you again. Amen. Let's sing, "What a Mighty God We Serve." Amen.
What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. The angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adores him. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Oh, what a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God. Angels bow. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Oh, what a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Oh, angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Oh, what a mighty God we serve. Oh, what a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Oh, what a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God. Oh, what a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God
Señor, conforme a tu voluntad, Señor, y que tú, Señor, haga como tú quieras. Yes. En el nombre de Jesús. Amén.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Se lo bendiga, hermano.
He's all over me. He's keeping me alive. He is keeping me alive. He's keeping me alive. He is all over me. He's keeping me alive. Oh, Jesus is keeping me alive. Él está sobre mí. Me guarda con poder. Él me guarda con poder. Él está sobre mí. Me guarda con poder. Oh, Cristo me guarda con poder. He's all over me. He's keeping me alive. He's keeping me alive. He's keeping me alive. He's all over me. He's keeping me alive. Oh, Jesus is keeping me alive. He is all over me. He is keeping me alive. He is all over me. He's keeping me alive, oh, Jesus is keeping me alive. Él está sobre mí, me guarda con poder, Él me guarda con poder. Él está sobre mí, me guarda con poder, oh, Cristo me guarda con poder. Y Él está sobre mí. Me guarda con poder. Y Él está sobre mí. Me guarda con poder. Oh, Cristo me guarda con poder. Y Él lo va a mí. Y keep me alive. Y keep me alive. Y Él lo va a mí. Y keep me alive. Oh, Jesus. Sobre mí, me guarda con poder, Él me guarda con poder. Y Él está sobre mí, me guarda con poder, oh Cristo. Oh, Él está sobre mí, me guarda con poder, Él me guarda con poder. Y Él está sobre mí, me yo era como modelo, Cristo. All over me, he's keeping me alive, he's keeping me alive. He's all over me, he's keeping me alive, oh Jesus. Oh, él está sobre mí, me guarda con poder, me guarda con poder. Me huela con poder, oh Cristo, me huela con poder. He is all over me, he's keeping me alive, he's keeping me alive. He is all over me, he's keeping me alive, oh Jesus, he's keeping me alive. He is all over me. He's keeping me alive, he's keeping me alive. He's all over me, he's keeping me alive, oh Jesus, he's keeping me alive.
Gloria a Dios.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Amén. Dios le bendiga una vez más. Dios bendiga también a nuestro pastor Joshua. Gloria a Jesús. Amén. Voy a permitir que me pasen la lista. Gloria a Jesús. Vive Jesús. Aleluya. Pueden alabar al Señor. Amén. Praise God. God is good. Amén. God is good. Aleluya. Vamos a comenzar primero para. And when I just say your name, amen, you can stand, praise God, and say your name, or, you know, as we say. If there's anybody in the congregation that we have not listed in here, amen, I would like, you know, for you guys to stand up and say your name. But so far we have Jadira and her daughter Skylar. Amen. Praise God. Amen. We welcome you. We welcome you in Jesus' house. Amen. Darlene, and it says here, Children Justice, Janita. Okay. I don't want to say it wrong. Amen. Praise God. Welcome. Amen. We have Natalie, Nathaniel, Destiny, and I can't get the last one. Amen. Diamond, okay. Amen. We welcome you. Sons of the Lord. Amen. And nosotros dimos, we gave out some flyers, dimos unos flyers. So we want to know quién fueron los que recibieron los flyers. Amen. Who received the flyers? Amen. So we welcome you. I see we, it wasn't in vain to give them out. Amen. I know we went into the Cooper Projects, the Cooper Park. We went to the Williamsburg, and we did a few, you know, outreach in the area. So I'm glad. Amen. God is doing his thing. Praise God. Sharon Greenwich. Oh, amen. Amen. Welcome. Welcome. Praise God. Amen. We have Randall. Oh, okay, so it's a whole family here. Amen. So we got you covered. So, you know, whenever you have time, come visit us. We're here on Tuesdays, Thursdays at 8 p.m. We're here on Sundays at 7 p.m. So we're the night church. Amen. So this church has a daytime church, which is another. They're the ones, you know, we fellowship with. Amen. That open the doors to our ministry. But our days are here on Tuesdays, Thursdays, like we said, and Sundays at 7. Para aquellos pues que no conocen, ¿verdad? Nosotros pues somos dos iglesias que están aquí, ¿verdad? Pero nosotros somos las que estamos aquí los martes y los jueves a las 8 de la noche y los domingos a las 7 de la noche. Okay? So we're Holy Fire Christian Church, Iglesia Cristiana Fuego Santo. Amen? So I hope you come and continue joining us. Amen? And amen. So there's nothing better than serving Jesus. Amen.
Yes.
And he's a good God. Praise God. Amen. También tenemos la iglesia Christ the Rock Church. Amen. 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 Yes. Amen. Praise God. Si el hermano tiene que salir, ok, yo quiero que lo excusen. Praise God. Ya él habló con nosotros. Amen. Amen. We're not a church that attacks. Amen. Because a veces, ¿verdad? No. Alguien se levantó, se fue porque no quiso oír la palabra. No, no, we understand. Amen. Daniel Santiago de Sol de Justicia. Amen. Si quieren decir unas palabras, si miraron con niños, venga y gócense por aquí, you know. Amen. Praise God. So, we don't have any more. Queríamos, ¿verdad?, que algunos de los niños si quisieran participar, pero como entendemos, praise God, no sé si el varón quiere decir unas palabras, gloria a Dios. Amen. So, esta noche tenemos, Dios bendiga a hermano Ulises, gloria a Jesús. Amen. Tenemos para aquellos que, no sé si, bueno, mi hermana, amen, estuvo pasando para decirle que hay una rifa. There's a raffle here tonight. Amen. We don't normally accustom it, but we're doing this for a pro fund of the church. Amen. Estamos haciendo esto por un profundo de la iglesia. Amen. Y the raffle is $5. La rifa es de $5. Y es para estas dos canastas que están aquí. For these two baskets that are here. And it has a lot of great products for the house. You know that if you go buy it individually, it's going to be a whole handful of, you know, you're going to spend a lot. So right here is just for $5 and you're benefiting the church. So es $5 y está beneficiando la iglesia. Amen. So aquellos que están interesados pueden verse con mi hermana y pues, cojan un tiquecito, gloria a Jesús, y más luego vamos a estar, ¿verdad? Dando esa oportunidad a mi hermana para que ella pues, yeah, you can do it. Amen. So, en esta noche, mientras nuestro hermano Ulises, ¿verdad?, pues se prepara, pues nosotros, gloria a Jesús. Amen. You wanna say? Amen.
God bless you all. Dile, hermano, que se le bendiga. As I stated various times before, my name is Sister Crystal. Soy la hermana Cristal. I would really like to thank my sister, Pastor Reverend Omaira, for giving me the opportunity to see my vision of my giving ministry, which is Jehovah Jireh Giving Ministry. But I understand that everyone has, you know, they can't, you know, if someone can't afford the ticket, but you're interested in the raffle, what I'm gonna do right now, what God has put in my heart, I will do 5 tickets. Whatever you can give, I will match it up to the $5. So if you're interested in the raffle, if you give $1, I'll put the 4. If you put 3, I'll put the 2. So I'll do this for 5 tickets. So if you're really interested in the ticket, and I understand, we all go through trials and tribulations. We all go through moments that we don't have. You know, that's why we're here giving back to the community. We're here to the service of the community. That's what God has called us for, to give. And, you know, this is bridging the gap. So I'm bridging the gap right now. So I can do it up to 5 tickets. So if you're interested, I will be in that corner over there. If, like I stated before, if you give $1, I'll match you to 4. If you give 4, I'll match the 1. So I just wanted to say that God has put that in my heart, because I do want everybody to take an opportunity. And it's also going to the church. And I know that my sister Omari does a great job. She goes out there, we give all God honor and glory to God that she goes out to the community and she reaches out with her family and Pastor Joshua as well. So you can see me, I will be in that little corner over there. So I just wanted to say that, and God bless you all, and I will give the part to Hermano Ulises. We will have Brother Ulises with the offering, so we will be collecting the offering. So pasa por acá, Hermano Ulises, Dios te bendiga, God bless you. Amén.
Hermano, el Señor bendiga. Me voy a disculpar porque llegué tarde, me acosté tarde y me levanté tarde. Me acosté por el día. Bueno, vamos a cantarle un coro para el Señor. Un coro de los que me gustan, de los viejitos. Si tuviera fe como un granito de mostaza, eso lo dice el Señor. Si tuviera fe como un granito de mostaza, eso lo dice el Señor, tú le dirías
Praise the Lord, amen. Vela, yo voy a permitir que nuestra hermana Frida, yo no sé si tiene una alabanza para el Señor. O la cogí de sorpresa. Amen. Praise God. I don't know, because no tengo otra, no sé si hay otra iglesia medio nuestro, ¿verdad? Que no hemos representado. Praise God. Y no queremos que se sienta nadie mal. Praise God. If there's any other church that's present tonight, we have not put them on the list. Please let us know. We don't want anybody to feel. Amen.
Refuge.
Amen. So, the refugio de Dios. Amen. Thank you. Oh, Evelyn? Oh, amen. Okay, so right after. Amen.
Praise the Lord. A su nombre.
Gloria.
Praise the Lord. Voy a cantar un corito, no voy a cantar la banda. Me cogieron de sorpresa. Praise the Lord. Victory. Victory, victory shall be mine. Victory, victory shall be mine. And if I hold my peace and let the Lord. Oh, my God.
Gloria a Jesús. Amén. Dios bendiga. Nuestra hermana Evelyn. Aleluya. Dios le bendiga. Gloria a Jesús. Well, we have, ¿verdad? Vamos a estar repartiendo los bultos. Gloria a Jesús. Amén. Necesitamos ayuda. So. Pastor, I'm going to have Ashley and Crystal, if you could help us out to give out the bags, amen. And I'm going to ask Bella para que los niños hagan una fila, gloria a Jesús. Amen. Amen. So all the children, Bella, we want to ask them to form a line, amen, as we give out the book bags. Make a line, make a line. Praise God. Okay, so we want to make a form a line, line. Amen. So, on behalf of our church, Holy Fire, yes, we're going to have cereal boxes for them too. On behalf of Holy Fire Christian Church, Crew in the City, and Legacy Center, we have these book bags for our community, our children, amen, the youth also, and we just want to distribute them, and we have a cereal box for them. De parte de la Fundación Crew in the City y Legacy Center, hold on, Joel, because we're going to do it by one at a time, so it wouldn't get crazy. De parte de Legacy Center y Crew in the City y nuestra iglesia, estamos dando estos bultos, ¿verdad? Para aquellos que regresan a la escuela, gloria a Jesús, aún la juventud, gloria a Jesús. Amen. So, una caja de cereal también va acompañada. So, it's a huge blessing. Y le voy a pedir, ¿verdad? Que cada uno sea paciente. Each one of you be patient. We want to take down the names. Queremos tomar los nombres, ¿verdad? Para así saber, ¿verdad? Quién estuvo y el próximo año puedan, ¿verdad? Nosotros podemos llamarle. So the next year we'll take down the names and the phone number so we could contact you that we're having the back to school event, which we do yearly. Que tenemos este regreso a la escuela servicio que hacemos anual. Gloria a Jesús. Okay. So we have a suggestion. Since there's not many, we have enough bags to cover everybody, we have enough cereal boxes. I don't know if you guys want to choose your color.
Black.
And the cereal box. So we're going to bring it. You just say which cereal box you want and what color book bag you want. Yes.
So we have available...
There's limited amount of boxes of Lucky Charms. We have Honey Nut Cheerios, Blueberry Chex. A limited amount of Blueberry Toast Crunch, Apple Toast Crunch, and a limited amount of Strawberry Toast Crunch. So, you can see Brother Joel, and you guys can choose your cereal. So you can start off the school year with a healthy breakfast.
Praise God. Amen. So once you get your book back, you go straight to Joel, the one on your right hand side. Amen. So, all right. Oops. And we also have these. So these are nice too. And we have the string bags.
No. Okay.
Oh, and also, if you guys go into our website, we are iglesiafuegosanto.org, iglesiafuegosanto.org, and you can find out of all the events of the church as well. So what color? To leave early, so this is why I'm asking for all the children, can you pass up front? And we want to pray, you know, that God brings protection over them, amen? And all the kids, we want to bless them, amen? Amen? And I'm going to run out Sister Nydia to pray for them, amen?
They're going to pray for you.
God bless you all. I want all the kids to hold each other's hand. Come on, hold your hand. Let's do a chain. Let's do a circle. That's a lot of kids. Come on, Mia. Make a list. Do a prayer chain. Come on. Everybody hold hands. Everybody's holding hands? Yeah, everybody hold hands. Come, hold my hand, come. Everybody's holding hands?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna pray, okay? Everybody close their eyes. Close your eyes, Mia. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come into your presence, giving you honor and glory and thanks, Father God, for these children. I ask you right now, in the name of Jesus, Father God, that you may protect them, Father God, that they go into school, Father God, soon. I ask that you may put your angels around them, my God, and that you may put, Father God, your guard, Father God, over them, my God. In the name of Jesus, I ask, Father God, that you, Father God, may give them wisdom and knowledge, Father God, so they may pass their test, Father God, and they may do, Father God, what you want them to do according to your will, Father God, your way, my God. In the name of Jesus, I ask for protection, Father God, because you only know, Father God, what's going to happen, my God. So right now, in the name of Jesus, I rebuke, Father God, every, Father God, hallelujah, spirit, Father God, that wants to, Father God, take them away, Father God, from the studies, my God. In the name of Jesus, I ask you, amen, amen.
Praise God.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Praise God. For me, it's very important because we are living in tough times. Amen. Even the education is being hindered. Amen. And they're teaching our children things that are not even proper. Amen. So we just want to, you know, pray upon our children because it's very important. Praise God. And later on, for those that still have not yet have Jesus in their heart and wants to accept the Lord right after the message, we got a special prayer as well. Amen. So tonight, we want everybody, you know, that if you are visiting for the first time, may you not leave out of this place without having Jesus into your heart. Amen. I guarantee you, amen, I guarantee you he's going to do so much great in your life, amen. Aquellos que no conocen del Señor, ¿verdad? Es su primera vez en la casa del Señor, ¿verdad? Queremos, ¿verdad? Que si alguno, ¿verdad? No ha conocido al Señor, amen, que esta noche se lleva a Jesús en su corazón, amen, amen, y le garantizo que le va a hacer muy bien, praise God, amen. No decimos que va a ser un camino perfecto, sino que Dios le va a ayudar, praise God. Hacer la carga más liviana, praise God, amen, praise God. So en esta noche, vamos antes del mensaje, queremos, I don't know if Crystal's ready to get this over with the baskets, amen, because we want to jump right into the message, amen. Okay. Last call for the tickets. No, okay. I think. Amen. I want to shake it. I need a bath.
Amen. Let's praise God. Let's give him the worship, because he is worthy. Let's give him a hand worship. Let's give him a hand worship, because we are alive today. We are here. You know, with the things going on in Houston, Texas, we could be underwater. There's people who have lost their homes, lost their families. We have somewhere to go. We have a school to go to. I know the kids don't want to go to school, but there's kids in Texas that don't have they can't learn right now. So let's give him the praise and the honor. Let's take one moment to worship. Let's stand up. Let's take one moment to worship. Just sit there and invite the Holy Spirit. Invite him. Invite him into. Just praise him. Just praise him. Just praise him. Praise him because he is worthy. He is worthy to be praised, my Lord. We have things right now. We have a home to go to. We have schools to go to. We have food on the table, Father God. There is a hurricane coming, and we don't know if it's coming our way. We can face the same destiny as Houston right now. But let's give him the honor and worship him while we still have breath, while we still have life. The word of God says in Psalm 150, everything that has breath, praise God. Do you know that? Do you know that a rock will worship the Lord if you don't do it? I know that you don't want that to happen. So let's praise him. Let's praise him. Let's praise him. Thank you, Jesus, for you are worthy, my Lord. Thank you, Jesus. You are worthy. You are worthy to be praised, my Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We praise and magnify your holy name. You are so merciful. You are beautiful, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus, Father God, it's so wonderful, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to call the princess of the church, Natalie. Natalie. Okay, we're going to pick. You're going to pick one. Okay, one. Okay. Okay, and then there's two baskets. And then shake it, shake it, shake it. I'm gonna pick the other one. Okay. Okay. I know the names, but I'm just gonna say the name and the number to give anticipation. 8. Everybody look at your tickets. Look at your tickets. It's funny because it's a male and a female. I just wanna let you know that when I made these, God put it in my heart to make these baskets. I made it with a male and a female. So there's a male shaver and a female shaver and all that good stuff. So a male and a female happen to win. So look how God works. Ain't God good? God knows all things. So now I'm just gonna give you the number just because I just wanna be. 8, 5, 8, 6, 9, 5. Brother Daniel, come on over. Be blessed, brother. Be blessed. Be blessed. All right. And the next one is a female. So all my females. So if you're a male, I'm sorry. This one's a female. 8, 5, 8, 6, 9. Who said that people who worship the Lord don't have fun? I don't know. I don't know about you. 3. Yes. Praise the Lord. And there's a lot of goodies. There's not, like I said, you open it, you be blessed.
Thank you.
And I will leave it. Let's give a hand worship. Praise Jesus. And thank you, because these funds do go to Holy Fire Christian Church. My sister does so much for the community and so much to give back. And it all, you're right. It's not for us. It's for the glory and honor goes to God. So I'm gonna leave. I'm gonna stop being loud right now. I'm gonna stop being Puerto Rican, and I'm gonna give this to.
Jesus. Amen. So, vamos a tener por aquí nuestra hermana evangelista Nidia Torres, evangelist Nidia Torres, and she's going to bring the word. Ella traerá la palabra. Gloria a Jesús. Amen. Y lo importante aquí que we don't tell them what to, you know, what to read or what to preach. It's what the Spirit of the Lord says. Amen.
Dios le bendiga a todos. Dios le bendiga más. God bless you all. I'm going to preach English today. I'm going to go English today. Everybody can talk in English. I got too comfortable now. Before I start the message, I want my little cousin, Angelia. Come here. Come here. And yeah, she's almost taller than me. I say little cousin. You don't stand too close, then they know your height. I want you to sing the song. Que me falta todo. Okay?
No song.
She's gonna sing. And when she sings, everybody worship God.
Yes.
Because I'm seeing like everybody's like,
praise the Lord.
You're supposed to be in one mind, one spirit.
Yes.
Yes. What a chord.
You know?
Yes.
So I'm gonna leave her. You remember the song, right? I'll sing.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. God bless my little cousin, Angelia. God bless her more.
Amen.
Who say that children don't have talent?
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
I do that so that way she can keep on going. She could learn about the ministry more and more. I want everybody to stand up. I'm noticing nobody's worshiping. Everybody got what they wanted, but they don't want to worship. Remember, we're still in church.
Yes, that's right. Thank you, Lord.
Let's lift up our hands. And let's start to worship God. Because where there is two or three, God is there. Glory to God, hallelujah. Like the pastor said, glory to God, my name is Evangelist Lydia Torres. I come from the church Flower Lebanon, 494 Broadway, which my pastor is Jose Cotto. Mi alma te alaba Jesús.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
I'm not going to push you to worship God. Because the Bible says that when you enter through that door, you got to have a praise at all times. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Because there's a secret in that worship.
Thank you, Jesus.
Let's open up our Bibles. I'm not going to stay long. Don't worry. Let's open up to Acts chapter 16. Acts chapter 16, verse 25 and 26. Hecho capítulo 16, versículo 25 y 26. We worship you, Jesus. Acts chapter 16, verse 25 and 26. We worship you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, my God.
Everybody has it? Let's read it in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Oh, only one. In the name of the Acts chapter 16. Ready? In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I'm at home. And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God. And the prisoners heard them. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundation of the prison was shaken. And immediately all the doors were open, and everyone's bands were loose. Y'all may be seated.
Thank you.
Glory be the name of God.
Thank you, my God.
I know you guys are not in prison, so you guys should be worshiping God.
Thank you, Lord.
The name of the theme that God has given me is praise through your pain. Sometimes we have to praise through our pain just to get to where we need to get to. My God, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
You see, Paul and Silas, in this story, they were beaten. They even had stripes. Glory to God, hallelujah. They had so many cuts and wounds because they said the truth. Just like us nowadays, spiritually speaking, we have a lot of wounds. But God is telling you through those wounds, praise his living name, and you're going to see what's going to happen. My God, hallelujah. You see, Paul and Silas, they did not care that they were locked up. All they were worried about was one thing. They were just giving the honor and glory to God. Yeah, even though they passed through what they passed through, it didn't matter. Because they knew that God was going to do something for them. They knew that Jesus was going to come through for them. So it's the same way that the church needs to be nowadays. Even though we're going through what we're going through, the situations, the circumstances, all you have to do is look up to the living name of God and tell God, God, you take over everything. The only thing that I can do is just worship you. Is that sometimes the church don't understand what it is to worship. We live in a routine of that we sing three chorus, and then all of a sudden we sing the coro ofrenda, and then we just say hallelujah, glory to God, only two or three times. But really, in reality, that is not the worship God is looking for. You see, the worship that God is looking for is within. It's a sacrifice. So if you know it's a sacrifice, so it's going to hurt. My God. Oh, God.
Thank you, Lord.
This is why God is telling you, praise through your pain. I don't know what you're going through, but if you praise it out, something has to happen in your life. The chains got to break. The demons got to flee when you start to worship the living name of God.
I got my blue nails.
It is not easy. And when you're going through a sickness, people telling you, praise God. It is not easy. But when you learn and you sit there and you say, even though I'm going through this sickness, I know there's one that can heal me.
Yes.
My God, hallelujah.
Jesus.
Even though I'm going through the sickness, I know there's one that can extend his hand when he hears my worship. He might have mercy and heal me.
Yes. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
But we gotta give up sacrifice. That's why God tells you worship through your pain. Because it doesn't matter what you're going through.
Yes.
There's always a way out.
That's right.
Just like Paul and Silas. They got beaten because they said the truth.
Yes.
They got criticized.
Yes.
And the most thing is that when you read it, they didn't put them in a regular cell. No, they put them all the way under where nobody can hear them. My God.
That's right. Yes.
And that's what happens to us. Our spirit ends up somewhere down deep. The devil puts you in a situation, and it's so deep that sometimes you want to scream and you cannot scream.
Yes. That's right.
And when you're screaming, you're thinking nobody's hearing you. My God.
Yes.
That's what was going on with Paul and Silas. They said, you know what? It doesn't matter where I'm at. I'm going to start screaming and shouting.
That's right, yeah.
Because I know that something's going to have to happen. God is going to have to do something. So it didn't matter what they went through. They didn't care the way they were. They started worshiping the living name of God. And when they started worshiping, something had to happen. There was an earthquake that just happened. And that's what's going to happen in our lives today. We're not going to leave the same. God is going to shake us loose, because it's not every day that you're standing and walking spiritually. There's sometimes we're down. There's sometimes that we need help. And sometimes we need to scream, God, help me.
Yes, that's true. Thank you, Jesus.
Through the pain and through the suffering. So this is why God tells you, although you go through what you go through, just worship me. God made our tongues to worship, not to criticize, not to talk about one another. What he made it for is to worship him. To bless those, to help those. A lot of people say they know Jesus and they know about Jesus. But really, they don't understand who Jesus really is. A lot of the whole multitude walked with him and still didn't know who he was. They worshiped his name and didn't know that he was the one that was God. So how can you worship something when you don't know what it is? My God. You see, so when you do have a relationship with God, Paul knew that if he mentioned the name of Jesus, he already knew how powerful it was, because he already had an experience.
That's right.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Like many of us today, we have experience with the Lord.
Yes. Yes.
But we start doubting on him.
Amen.
We want God to answer our prayers. We want God to do a lot of things for us, to bless us. But then we start doubting.
Yes.
But when you start worshiping God and start talking to him and telling him in spirit and truth, Father God, I really need you.
Yes.
I'm not nobody.
Yes.
You are the one that created me.
That's right.
You know me. I may not know everything, but you do.
Yes.
When we start to humble ourselves,
yes,
and we start to give it all to the Lord and take off everything, my God, hallelujah, God has to do something for you.
Amen.
Paul and Silas, knew that something was going to happen. They didn't care where they were. It's not like many Christians nowadays. You walk outside, they don't even say God bless you to you. You see a Christian passing by, and they just look at you and are you saying God bless you to her?
Come on.
Because she wears a dollar coat and I wear a $100 coat. This is how it is nowadays.
Yes.
The pride is so up there.
Yes.
Did they forget how to even worship God?
Yes.
That when God gives them a ministry, my God, hallelujah. When they start with their ministry, they start low and they start to worship God and bless God all the time. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you for this. Now, all of a sudden, now that they're doing miracles and they're doing a lot of things, even worshipers that they started worshiping at one point in time, now they got CDs and everything. They don't even want to worship God.
That's right. Yep. That's right.
Thank the Lord. The pride gets to them.
Yes.
But when there's one that is humble, one that doesn't matter if you go through the pain in the situation, they take everything off, spiritually speaking, and they say, God, here I am. I want you to fix me.
Amen.
Nowadays, right. It's not like that. Now, because I got a ministry, I'm a singer, I'm a pastor.
That's right.
I'm an evangelist. I don't need to worship God as much.
Yes.
Because the anointing flows through me. That's the new thing that's going on.
That's right. Tell the truth. Come on.
I walk past by and they be healed. They think they're Peter.
Come on.
But yet they're not even close.
That's right.
Why? Because they don't know how to worship.
Yes.
Because the Bible says he's looking for those who are in spirit and truth.
Yes.
To worship him.
Yes.
And not many are in the spirit at times.
Amen.
But when God tells you, worship him, don't stay still. It's because he wants to do something to your life.
Amen.
He wants to break those chains.
That's right.
Nobody's perfect.
That's right.
I say these things because the way that I pass through these situations, it hasn't been easy in my life. But when the Lord tells me, don't worry about it, just worship me. You're going to see what I'm going to do. So when I start to tell the Lord, I can't no more, you take over. God starts to open up to the heavens and start saying, listen, my child is calling me. My child needs me. She's worshiping me. She's taking everything off and letting me do what I have to do.
Amen.
That's what Paul and Silas did. And all of a sudden, there was an earthquake.
Yes.
All of a sudden, the chains were broken.
Yes.
And that's what's going on in our lives. He's starting to break every chain.
Yes, every chain.
And all you have to do is just say the name of Jesus.
Yes.
You can't say nothing else, just say Jesus.
Yes.
I guarantee you, with just that name, something has to happen. The chains gotta break. The people who are sick have to be healed.
Jesus.
When my mom died in my arms, all I couldn't say was Jesus.
Hey,
Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus. All of a sudden, I started to feel an anointing over my life.
Yes.
I started to feel strength over my life. The Holy Spirit told me, stand still, that I will fight for you. You're going to see the glory of God. All you have to do is just worship me, Nidia. Worship me, Nidia. And you're going to see what's going to happen.
Thank you, Jesus.
8 years later, she's still alive. Because it was worship also. The faith. See, when we unite and we start worshiping, you feel the Holy Spirit like never before over your life. Now and then, there's no unity at all. One is worshiping, the other one is talking. The other one is talking, the other one is looking at the other one wrong. The other one's looking at the other one that what they're wearing. And come on. When God did not call you for that. God called you to come in and worship him. Don't worry who has hair, don't have hair, who has sneakers, who don't. Just start worshiping God. You're going to see what's going to happen in your life. Remember, we got to remember is that when we come into the church,
We don't remember where we came from. But when you start to remember where you come from, and you start telling God, thank you for taking me out of there, the church is like a hospital. It has every kind of effect. Some people got different things than others. Some people got it stronger than others. We just got to learn how to deal with it. And when you see that the brother's down, lift them up. Come on, I'm going to pray with you. Let's worship together. Paul and Silas did. You didn't see Paul fighting with Silas. Oh, you got me arrested. Because you took out the demon from the lady. You didn't see them fighting in there. What they did was that they started worshiping God. And it was so powerful and an impact that they worshiped God that not only their chains were broken, but those that were inside the cell was broken. So how many people, if we were here worshiping God right now, that the souls would be passing by and God would break their chains?
Thank you, Jesus.
We got to learn what it is to praise God. Worship and praise are two different things. They got that all twisted in there. They think that praise is for humbleness, and it's not. It's worship is when you really humble yourself and cry out loud. Praise is when you exalt in the Lord, bringing him higher. Worship is when you're giving your all. But since a lot of people, they tend to know a lot of things, when the Bible says if you think you know it all, you don't know nothing. Many start to preach the word of God and now they're twisting it. But when you do have knowledge and understanding from up there and God gives it to you, all you do is worship God, God is going to give you everything. But it is time for the church to be united. I remember back then when the anointing of God used to flow like never before, because they were united. They didn't care who was wearing what. They just had their eyes closed and they would worship God. You see prostitutes and drug addicts coming in and giving themselves up to God. Nobody even had to touch them. Nowadays you got 20 people touching somebody. And not touching them to pray for them. They touching them to take them out of the church. Because they distracted the church. How do we want to win souls that way? How do you expect the souls to worship God if the church is not worshiping? It makes me laugh because sometimes I come in churches and they don't worship God. When the Bible says that the angels are saying holy, holy, holy 24/7. And then when we go up there, we're going to keep on praising God. So why is it that you always tired when you come in and you don't want to praise God? Because of a situation, because you had a fight with your husband. Oh, I'm not going to praise today. I'm going to be like this in church. God didn't do nothing to you. Mijo or mija, if it was your husband, just pray for them. God will break the chain. If it was your child, pray for them. Leave them in the hands of God. But the problem is that you're bringing everything in. Instead of giving it to the Lord, you're just holding it. Stop being selfish. Give it to him. Let him deal with it. We got to learn how to praise. It's that we're accustomed to the evangelist to have to come and tell you, oh, praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. And then every time, it's like a robot. You pressing the button. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. Amen. I'm like, what's going on here? Because this is what happens. Alaba Dios, and then everybody's hallelujah. I'm like, come on. When the Bible says if you are grateful, la palabra dice, si tú estás agradecido de lo que Dios ha hecho por ti, tú tienes que tener una alabanza continua en tu boca. Pero hoy en día no se ve eso. Por eso el Señor te está diciendo, abre tu boca.
Levanta tu mano. No importando a dónde tú estás. Que Dios tiene algo grande para ustedes. Usa lo que Dios ha puesto en tu mano. Que cuando tú lo uses, mira, la cadena se cae. Los yugos se pudren. La situación que tú estás pasando, Él lo convierte, gloria a Jesús, aleluya, en bendiciones. Pero tú tienes que alabar a Dios en todo tiempo. Que cuando tú estás pasando por una situación, I give it to, I'm not trying to put you out there, but I give it to the Pastora Almeida. She lost her husband. She just passed away anniversary. And through the pain and suffering, she's still worshiping God.
That's right.
She didn't give up.
That's right.
She didn't say, oh, I'm going to give in. She said, I'm going to put it in your hands, Lord.
Yes.
It's the same way that we have to do.
Yes.
You see, because when you put God first,
yes, that's right,
the things come out right. That's why God always tells you, put me first.
Yes.
But we forget. We start to tend to worship other things instead of worshiping Him.
Yes.
But today, God is going to break those chains.
Yes.
Praise through your pain.
Yes.
So the pain that you're feeling now, spiritually, I don't know what you're going through, but we're going to give it in today.
Yes.
Church, stand up. I told you it wasn't going to be that long. The Bible says in Psalms 50, or 150, your sister said it. The Bible says in 150, verse 6, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. So if you know you have breath today, you're breathing now, start worshiping God.
Yes.
I want you to lift up your hands right now. Because we're not going to leave the same. Iva sakan dalayan soleve shaya. Amen dolebe kian soleyan dole. Oh, mi alma te adora, Jesús. Aleluya. Comienza a adorar a Dios a donde tú estás. Porque cuando tú levantas tu mano, tú le estás enseñando al diablo que tú estás en victoria. Oh, mi alma te alaba. Que cuando tú levantas tu mano, mira, agua, sacriando la ya. Aquellos que no le están sirviéndole a Dios, vuelve a servir al Señor. Gloria a Jesús. Aleluya. Pero es cuando tú levantas tu mano y das todo, todo. Todo a Dios. Ahí está el Espíritu Santo tocando. Ahí está el Espíritu Santo. Abba, sacata, andalaya, manzoleya, rompiendo cadena. Ahí está el Espíritu Santo. Oh, mi alma te alaba, Jesús. Oh, Rebequí, andalaya, soleya. Oh, mi alma te alaba, Jehová. There's an earthquake that is about to happen.
Yes.
And spiritually, I'm speaking. There's an earthquake that's about to happen over your life. Oh, God is going to change the situation around. Oh, espiritualmente hablando, Dios va a cambiar todo. Hay un terremoto que viene y va a romper, mira, las cadenas. Y va a sacar, rebasa aquí, dando laya, lo que no es de él. Él limpiando su casa. Te adoramos, te adoramos, te adoramos. Oh, Espíritu Santo de Dios. Oh, Espíritu, Abba, Shende, Leyan, Soled. Oh, gloria, gloria, gloria. Oh, gloria, gloria, gloria. Come on,
stand.
Mi alma, mi alma, te alaba Jesús, aleluya. Mi alma, mi alma, mi alma te glorifica. Oh, Espíritu Santo. Oh, Espíritu Santo. My God, aleluya. Eso es lo que Él quiere, aleluya. Si los ángeles están diciendo Santo, Santo, Santo. Santo, Santo, Santo. Dele gracias a Dios que tú puedes decir, yo te adoro. No hay nadie como tú. Tú vives para siempre. Oh, mi alma te alaba, Jesús. Aleluya. La cadena se está rompiendo en este momento. Poderoso, poderoso, está dando nueva fuerza en este momento. Oh, Espíritu Santo, aleluya. En este mismo comunión, mi mamá va a cantar. Sigue adorando a Dios.
Venga, Señor, mi condición, porque no hay que me comprenda. Oh, nadie sabe, Señor, mi sufrimiento. Oh, nadie sabe, Señor, lo que yo siento.
Esa paz, eso, lo tuyo puede dar.